Live from WFSB, Connecticut's number one local news, this is Channel 3 Eyewitness News at 7.
Good morning, everyone. It is Tuesday, November 24th. I'm Nicole Nalepa, and we start you off with the latest on the coronavirus in Connecticut. Numbers continue to rise across the country and right here at home. The state's positivity rate is now more than 4.8%. Over the weekend, 43 people with COVID died, and 875 people are now hospitalized with the virus. As coronavirus cases continue to rise, Connecticut is calling on neighbors to take action and help in the fight against the pandemic. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Aya Galal shows us where the need is greatest.
Help is wanted in the fight against the coronavirus. The state has launched Step Up Connecticut in hopes of encouraging more people to make a difference in the state's COVID-19 response. The Step Up Connecticut team needs substitute teachers and volunteers to distribute food to those who need to stay home.
Look, you could binge watch Netflix for 3 weeks, but we have some other ways that you can really be of assistance helping your entire community get through this pandemic.
The state says volunteers and flexible staff are a critical part of how Connecticut can make sure residents have access to what they need during the pandemic. And with a significant increase in the number of people getting tested for COVID, help is needed at testing sites.
Handing out registration forms, doing some basic data entry by registering folks in our computer system, and then the clinical role of actually doing the nasal swab.
Aya Galal, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
And you can head to the Channel 3 app for more on how you can help the state. The state says there is a job for everyone, regardless of experience. You'll get trained and in some cases, paid.
All right. Hi, everybody. Good morning. Let's take a look at our Doppler. It's dry. We are looking at a pretty good day of weather today. It's going to be a little on the chilly side. Temperatures out there, what a beautiful sunrise it is. 33 in Kent, 32 in Storrs. Numbers are a little bit above average, 31, the typical overnight low. I mean, is this not a spectacular? Old Saybrook?
Look at that.
Absolutely gorgeous this morning.
That's our moment of calm this morning.
That is our moment of calm this morning. Enjoy it. Look at this beautiful painting in Waterbury. Absolutely gorgeous there as well. And we'll take you to New Haven. Equally as nice there. The sun was up at about, I think it was 6:47 this morning. Middletown, good morning, good morning. Beautiful, right? All right, let's take a look at some of the numbers in from you. Hampton, 30. Mansfield Center, 28. That's a little chilly. 36 in East Hampton. The typical overnight low is about 31 again. So we're doing a little bit better than that in Killingworth, but a little bit cooler than that in North Granby and South Windsor. All right, so headline number one, mostly sunny during the day today. Yay! Lots of sunshine. Temperatures in the mid-40s for inland Connecticut. Lots of sunshine for the shoreline. Temperatures in the mid-40s there as well. Maybe a degree or two warmer than where they're headed inland, but all in all, a nice day. More temperatures for you. 26 is the cool spot in Meriden. 41 is the warm spot in New Haven. Everybody's sandwiched in between, and the winds, they're anywhere from 5 to 6 to about 5 to 6 miles an hour, so that's adding a little bit to the chill. But the temperature differential from yesterday, whoa, 27 degrees colder in Chester this morning than it was yesterday, 25 in Norwich, 23 in Meriden, so it's a little chilly out there this morning. Grab that winter coat. Tomorrow is cloudy, but dry. As you can see, high pressure dominates. It's going to take a while for the next batch of rain to roll in. Unfortunately, it comes in for Thanksgiving. Yay! All right, Tuesday, today, looking good. Let's fast forward here. Tomorrow is cloudy. Thanksgiving is wet. Let's fast forward to Wednesday, tomorrow night. So we're just under mostly cloudy skies, but then here comes the rain for Thursday. This is Thursday morning. Some showers, some drizzle, some fog. Rain could be heavy at times. 8 o'clock in the morning, that's not too good. Rain could be heavy at times at 11. Rain could be heavy at times at 4, and then it finally winds down Thursday night late. We'll start to see some gradual clearing. Mostly sunny, breezy, and chilly during the day today. Temperatures topping out in the mid-40s. Overnight lows tonight, partly to mostly cloudy. A cold night. Temperatures dropping into the low to mid to upper 20s. And then tomorrow, 50. That's exactly where we should be, a little bit above average by 2 degrees. Maybe a rain or a snow shower in the morning. Mostly cloudy tomorrow. Rain for Thursday. Not looking good. Friday, much better. 60 degrees with mostly sunny skies. Saturday, a chance for a shower as a cold front moves through. Sunday, 55 degrees. Beautiful day on Sunday. And then rain expected for Monday. That's a check of your early warning forecast. Meteorologist Scot Haney at Channel 3. Hope you have a great day. Nicole, back to you.
All right. Thanks, Scot. Many teachers are calling for remote learning across Connecticut unless state leaders can take several steps to make classrooms safer. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Roger Suzanne shows us what teachers are demanding.
Yesterday, several unions comprised of Connecticut educators, including the state's largest teachers union, issued a report claiming that as COVID numbers rise, classrooms across Connecticut are not safe enough. Their plan is simple. They say all schools should go fully remote after Thanksgiving through Martin Luther King Day on January 18th to help minimize the spread of COVID-19 after the holidays, unless the statewide standards in this document are implemented and schools are fully staffed. The safety improvements these teachers are demanding include teacher input on contact tracing procedures, statewide safety protocols, stricter social distancing enforcement, full classroom quarantines after a positive test, and a statewide standard for quarantine length. Roger Suzannon, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Students in New Britain, though, will be learning online for 2 weeks after Thanksgiving, and this is because of staffing shortages. This comes after several teachers have been forced to self-isolate due to possible exposure. The district says students can plan to return for in-person learning the week of December 14th. The UConn women's basketball team has to hit the pause button on its season after someone in the program tested positive for the virus. All team activities are shut down for at least 14 days. This means the Huskies will not compete in their first 4 games that were all set to take place in Mohegan Sun. The UConn men's basketball team had to shut down a month ago and just started up again last week. Thank you so much for tuning in to Eyewitness News on this Tuesday morning. Remember, you can get the latest news and weather updates anytime on the Channel 3 app. We'll leave you with some more sunshine. Stay healthy and stay positive.